Hello everybody and welcome back to Stardew Valley, where we have a lot to do today. We are going to go, definitely, and find the Junimos. Find the Junimos, gonna go and get their help with harvesting. Oh, look. The chickens are all outside. Yay, I got 2 iridium ore and I've got some post. Let's see. That's not my post. Dear SheLab, thanks again for coming to my art show. It was such a success. I sold nearly all of my sculptures and everyone was so positive and encouraging. I hope to see you again soon, Leah. Well, that's lovely. Hello friend, the mountain lake has been kind to me lately. I'd like to share my good fortune with you. Oh, it's a fish. What kind of fish is that? I haven't seen that before. Catfish? Oh, I think I have had a catfish before. Put that in the fish chest. Just got some room. It does indeed. I'm such a hoarder. Okay. Let's go say hi to all the chickens. See how they're feeling. And the bunnies. Hello, bunnies. So we're going to go and probably see if we can track down Elliot, because we are getting really close to the social with everyone really now. Maxing out the social. So we've just got Kent, who's got a birthday tomorrow, so I'll probably give him something nice, like a cranberry. Might even bring him a star fruit. I think he quite likes those. Alex is close, and Elliot is close. We should, on that point, we should plant some kale as well. But while we're waiting for all of that, I'll put some more strawberries through the seed maker. Probably should have prepared these, but you know, made them one that I prepared earlier or something. I'm gonna put the star fruit and stuff away, and maybe I've got strawberry seeds in my inventory. I'll put the tulip. Bulbs, no, not the pomegranate. The coconuts can go away. I don't even know if I can do anything with coconuts. I need to sell those star fruits. They're star fruit jellies! Good grief! They're gonna probably be worth quite a lot. I didn't even remember putting star fruit in there, but never mind. I'd probably do that again, actually. I have quite a lot of star fruit. No, don't eat one. Okay, that's a lot of strawberry seeds to plant, so I'll pop another couple in and I'll go out and plant them. Ugh. It's taking a while. Right, so put some there. Some up here. Some fertilizer down there. Out my way, Benjamin Bunny. Benjamin Bunny was in Beatrix Potter, I'm sure. I read that when I was little. It was Peter Rabbit and Benjamin Bunny, I'm sure it was. I think Benjamin was maybe like Peter's brother or something. Ah, I loved those stories when I was little. Although they definitely did give some sort of not very good advice on how to keep a rabbit. I mean, I think there's certain things that Peter Rabbit ate that were slightly toxic for rabbits. So yeah, probably not the best advice there. I want some kale seeds because I want to see if I can give Alex his favourite thing, which is salmon dinner, which is got kale and also possibly potatoes. Have we got any salmon? Yeah, we've kept 2, so I can do at least 2 for him if I can get some kale. Right, let's go get the more strawberries. I've got too much to do. Well, as long as the strawberries are planted by the end of the day, that's the main thing. So we've got some pomegranates, and we should take some eggs or something for Alex in case we see him. Let's see if we've got any eggs around anywhere. I normally keep some in a stupid place. Apparently not today. No. keeping all that garlic, because apparently garlic's like really good for going down the mines and beating monsters. It sort of you can make like a repelling potion with it or something. Okay, let's go. I've filled my inventory. But then if I go to buy the Junimo thing, then that might empty a few things out. Now then, let's see. Sam's around. Sam's already at 10 hearts. So Sebastian. Let's see if Elliot's in his shack. His tastefully decorated rustic cabin. The forest is a wonderful place. Have you been there? Yes, I have. Would you like a pomegranate? You're probably a bit fed up with them by now. It'd be funny if they put in a mechanic where, like, if you give them the same thing all the time, they get fed up with it. I think that would be funny. It's a beautiful gift, apparently, though. Still not fed up with it. Okay, he's fine. So let's see if that did what it needed to do. Because I've been giving him... It did indeed! So we can bring Elliot a bouquet now. A bouquet. Which would be pretty good. And then an egg to Alex, unfortunately. Best we can do. Alex, I think, is the last one now. Sebastian, Sam, Elliot, and we've done Shane, Harvey, Sebastian, Sam, Elliot, Alex. Yeah. So we nearly have all six boyfriends. That's just not good, is it? This is cool, thanks. Okay, so we're still at 7 out of 10. We'll have a little chat and see if we can boost that at all. Looks like a good day to play catch, huh? Still 7. Go along, just kidding. Ha ha ha. Okay. Next will be to go to the wizards, so we'll go down this way. All the way down the bottom and out here. And then we'll go and buy our Junimo harvester. And hopefully it'll fit our farm, because I didn't know about Junimo harvesters. Obviously they weren't invented when I started playing this game and designed my farm, so I'm hoping. It says that it goes across a quite large area, so I'm hoping it will go across my whole farm area and that I won't need to do too many alterations to it to make it fit. It'd be nice if I could just stick it like somewhere at the top of my farm and they would just go out and gather everything, but we'll see. Because you can't even try it. The problem is you can't even try it until you've actually bought the thing. Or at least got the stuff to buy the thing anyway. Right, so. Oh no! Star fruit! Oh, I put all my star fruit in the pots. Oh, I'm so stupid. Right, let's go back to the farm and see if we've got any more. Check the greenhouse, actually. There might be some more grown as well. That was so silly. This is what happens when they don't let me in because it's 11 o'clock at night and they suddenly put restrictions on things that didn't have restrictions before, and then I forget what I'm doing and then it all goes wrong. So that's what happens there. So it's not good. Oh, my grass starters are starting to do what they're meant to be doing, which is good. Okay, right, I need to go back to the shed, I think, and look in the juicy fruit chest and see if there's any star fruit in there. Can't believe that I had it all in my inventory as well. So there's 6. And there's another 5 there. Put stuff like that back away. Parsnip. Don't need the pomegranates for a little while. Just switch those around while I'm there. Right, Corthok, let's go back. Can't believe I rode all the way there and then I didn't have the star fruit. I hope it'll take star fruit of different qualities, or I am a bit scuppered. That was so stupid. Okay, back we go. I am quite excited to see what this Junimo harvester does, though, and how it works. He's got a lot of cool stuff, though. Like, it's definitely going to be worth trying to get like 1 million. There's a few things for 1 million that are quite good. End game content. No, don't eat the strawberry. Okay, so I've got the stuff there. So if I build that, it's a small structure. But I don't really know. It doesn't tell me its range. So, not sure really on that one. I'll build it here. And then we'll see. And if that is the wrong thing to do, then that will be a warning to all of you viewers out there that you don't want to put it in a certain place. So we'll see. We'll see. Hopefully it should cover the whole farm, but you never know. What are you doing down there, Leah? Hi, G-Lab. I was just thinking about you and your farm. I was imagining how good it must feel to harvest a big bunch of crops. Won't have to harvest them anymore. Wouldn't it be nice to have help, though? Yeah, from the Junimos. Don't need you to help. I need the Junimos to help. Oh yeah, apparently when you get married, they do help with things, so that's pretty cool. Right, so we're done with giving presents. We're done with seeing the wizard, and we've got our Junimo hut. So I hope that that helps. So we're going to spend probably the rest of the day now just planting more strawberries. And probably the next day we'll get some kale going as well. So I'm just going to just hoe out a few more patches there. I'm still needing to, I know I need to upgrade my hoe. But I have to do this like once a season. And probably like the next couple of seasons I'll only have to do it like the little bits to repair as well. It won't even be the whole patches. So and it barely takes any time. But just every couple of ones I do need to just pop in. I've got three at the moment. So I do just need to pop in and put more strawberries into the harvester thing. I'll run out of strawberries eventually. But hopefully there'll be some more in the greenhouse soon. So I've got three more strawberries that I can pop down here. We've got quite a lot of strawberries now, which is good. My pickaxe. Get rid of these. I hate stuff being in my way. I'm going to need an axe as well. I don't even know where my axe has gone. There's some more of those. I'm just going to go and see if there's any more strawberries in the greenhouse yet. I can't remember how often strawberries spawn. Yeah, we do. Very cool. And we've got no, more blueberries as well. And the star fruit is nowhere near. So I'm glad that it took a mixture of heart levels, sorry, star levels for the star fruit, or we would not have our Junimo thing. I can't wait to have a harvest now. See how it works. Oh no, this is getting frustrating. I need my axe. Now. Now, now, now. And my scythe. Don't really want grass growing there, to be honest. Though apparently it's starting to grow a bit more anyway. Okay. Get rid of weeds and stuff as well. But yeah, I need my axe. Where's it gone? There. Can put no, they need to go in the juicy fruit thing, but I'm gonna put a few bits and bobs just back in here. Things that are just random. Starfruit seeds, for example. Mixed seeds. Okay, that'll do. We'll plant some more strawberries. And we'll go and check on the strawberries that I put in there a minute ago and put some more strawberries in. And that's all the strawberries I just harvested. I think we only got about four, but it all helps. Because these, the more we can do, the quicker we can do them as well, the more we're going to get out of it, so. Especially because they've got sprinklers and Junimos. That means, like, you don't even have to bother watering them or harvesting them anymore. That's going to save me so much time. Especially with stuff like the cranberries. My goodness me. Just come and find 200 cranberries just sat in my little Junimo hut. It'd be so good. I just hope it works the way I think it works. It didn't tell me a range, so I imagine that they just go all around the farm and harvest everything. But we'll see. Right, I'm going to firstly go around and I'm going to get rid of as many weeds as I can. It's horrible around here. Weeds suck. Oh, we got truffles. Very nice. Thank you, piglets. I need to go and say hi to my piglets and things in the morning. I need to actually start doing that again. I had really good relationships with a lot of my animals and I've let them lapse. Because I've been too busy getting relationships together with people, to be honest. That grass is hurting my pathway. We've got honey. That's another thing we need to do very soon, is to get the flowers planted by the honey. Just pull that back a little bit. I'm going to run out of time today, aren't I? It's like 10 in the night already. Loads of honey to get. It's just wild honey. But as soon as I start planting flowers around it, it will become super honey. We have a lot of honey now as well. It's brilliant. That'll just sit there and make me money. And we've got pine tar. We'll slowly get this sorted out. We've got a lot planted now, to be fair. Right, let's go see if we can plant some more. Gonna run out of strawberries eventually. We've only got 4 left now. And then you don't have to see me planting quite so much as anymore, because I'll have to wait for the strawberries to grow and then plant more if I need to. I might get some seeds off of Pierre, like kale and things like that, but I'm not too worried. Just get some fertilizer on that one. See if we can get that patch planted at least. That's 3. So if we can get another 5 out of the next couple of things of strawberries, I will be able to plant that full patch. Don't know if I will though. We've got 3, I think. So that's the last of my strawberries. Just plant these 3. Somewhere with fertilizer. I mean, it won't hurt, like, because I've got the harvesting going on for free, hopefully it won't hurt that they are sort of coming into fruit at different times. Because when it was me harvesting, I'd like to harvest off every plant in a section, but the Junimos probably won't mind. But it's 1 in the morning now. I spent a long time doing a lot of stuff. I need to spend a bit of time redecorating my house as well. But we'll do that later. So it is the next day. It's Kent's birthday today. So I'm going to see if I can find him and take him a star fruit. But first I'm just going to check on all of my animals. G-Lab, I have great news. My novel is finished. I'm giving a public reading this afternoon at the library. Hope to see you there. Oh, we'd better go. That's cool. I'm enjoying getting all this iridium for free. That's pretty good. The strawberries are starting to grow properly now, so that's brilliant. We'll check the greenhouse in case there are any more strawberries. Say hi to all the chickens and the rabbits. Starting to like me a bit more now. I'm feeling like now we've done this whole thing with Grandpa, I am feeling a little bit more relaxed about everything. Definitely. Feel more like I can just, you know, mess around. No time limits now. We're just playing for fun. Is what I liked at the beginning of the game anyway. I hoe these up, just make a nice space here. Don't entirely know what's going in this space, but we can put something there, I'm sure. Right. I want to now come down to the honey area and decide where I want to put my jazz flowers. I don't have many of them, so I'm wondering whether I should just put them like right in the middle. But then we'd have to go and water them. Like every day. So what I could do is I could either do that, or I could just plant them all, plant a whole little bed of flowers and put a sprinkler in. And I know where there's some spare sprinklers. So I'm just going to do this, I think. I'm going to put a pathway in the middle so that the sprinklers don't get pulled up every time. But I'll probably just leave the flowers there, like a proper little flower garden. There we are. And I know that we don't need as many flowers as this, but I like the idea. And at this point, I have a lot of space in my farm, to be honest. So why not? I'm crafting and I want a stone floor. We've got all sorts of things we can make now. Stepping stone path. Those might be quite nice in between. Weathered floor. A straw floor. Or a wooden floor. We'll do cobblestone path a little bit anyway. That's one stone for those, so let's see what they look like. Let's put them in the middle. Oh, apparently I can't. Right, maybe I need to do this. And I can put them down. Yes. That's quite nice. I might do that for everything. Just as little sort of stone placeholders for the sprinklers. I think that would be quite nice. There we go. That there. Yeah, and then we put the sprinklers on top. Right, I need four sprinklers. And then I need a bunch more seeds. I won't bother fertilizing the ground, because as I say, I'm probably just going to leave them there. So, we've got four sprinklers here. We can just pull them up. I'll eventually, like, put them back or... I'll move those two up there, maybe. But we've still got a good amount of stuff where we haven't even planted anything yet, so... I'll work on it. Right, so I need four sprinklers. Go on top of there. That's good, I think. Oops, put that in the wrong place. So apparently, with that, when I then try and hoe around it or anything like that, it's... See, if I try and hoe that, it won't do anything. So that's then not going to pick my sprinkler up. So that's good. Right, where's my jazz seeds? Tulip bulbs, sorry. Oh, they'll be good for Evelyn. In fact, I'll make sure that there's sort of ones on each... I do need to get more, so I've got six. I need eight for each. So I need 26 more tulip bulbs. I'm sure Pierre can oblige. I need to make sure that I've got any strawberries that I need. Did I put the pomegranates away? Yes, I did. I can still give pomegranates to Elliot, so I need to... make sure I have them in me on inventory. Apparently also on Thursday and Friday I need to make sure I look in the sewers. So that is some advice someone has given me, so we'll go and do that. You can get to the sewers from the town as well, which is a lot easier, I think. So I want 26 tulip bulbs from Mr. Pierre. Lab, you're my number one customer. Probably your only one. I don't know of any other farms around here other than Marnie's Ranch, which doesn't really buy much. So 26 of those. And a couple of patches worth of kale seeds, I would say. And I think that'll do. Oh, we could do some potatoes as well, because I know... that's needed for the breakfast. And that's something that Alex likes as well, so it's definitely worthwhile having that. Of course. I'm like, I should put some pomegranates in my inventory, and then I don't. And then there he is, right there. There's Elliot. It's just the way my life works, really. Oh, we need to get to the sewer. Let's go and see Crowfoss, or whatever his name is. Crowfus. I will remember his name. Doesn't say his name. Oh well. I only have three. Oh yeah, I bought that. What? He sells a star drop on a Thursday. Return scepter, void egg, solar essence, and mixed seeds. Yes, we want some mixed seeds. So if I had 20,000, I could just buy a star drop off him. Wow. Do I have anything I can sell? Not really. I've spent a lot of money on my goods, so I think I also sold all the cranberries. So I'm unlikely to have enough to make 20,000. I might do. Is it Crobus? Is that his name? Crobus, I think it is. I can just call him Crocus. I'm gonna see if I've got enough stuff to sell. Because I had all of those jellies. I wonder if anyone would buy them. I wonder if, like... Because if I put them in the shipping crate, then I won't have them for tomorrow. I wonder if Pierre would buy them. I know he buys, like, straight up things. I don't know if he would buy jellies. By the time I've mucked around trying to find things to sell, I'll probably not have any stuff left to sell. Salmon berries. Alright, starfruit jelly. Honey. 100 odd blueberries. And 15 cranberries. And 4 cranberries there. I'm not going to sell the blackberries. Right, let's go and sell those to Pierre and see if we make 20,000. I doubt we will. 100 blueberries might get something. But I think blueberries are more prevalent, but less, bringing less of a price than cranberries, so we'll see. It'll be on the starfruit jelly. If he doesn't buy that, then we won't have enough money. Hi, can you buy stuff off me? Yeah, you can. Oh, 11,000 just for that. Wow. 1,000 for the honey. 700 for the truffles. Oh, would you look at that? $5,000 for the blueberries. 3,000 just for 3 starfruit. That's pretty amazing. That starfruit jelly, that was worth doing. Good grief. And Elliot's just standing there mocking me. Right, to the sewers, Corthok. We want our star drop. Thank you for the people that told me that Krobus has rotating stock. I think I've got his name right now. He sells void eggs. Crystal floor. That sounds nice. A wicked statue. That doesn't sound so nice. Star drop. 372 to 406. That was a really good increase. You found a star drop. It's strange, but the taste reminds you of chocolate. Your maximum energy level has increased. Oh yeah. Thanks, Crowbus. I wonder if he has one like every week or whether that's just like his only one. That's pretty cool though. He may have that all the time. But I'll go and check him tomorrow because I think he has something else on a Friday. Okay, where are we going now? Yeah, back to the farm and we're gonna plant these tulips. I want the farm looking right. I've got all week to give Elliot another. Oh no! Oh, you know what? Let's see if Kent's in, quick. Because it's his birthday and we nearly forgot. See if he's in his house. Who's that? Is that Jody? Yes. Kent's not there. Oh, how annoying. Right, where would he be? Sometimes he wanders around outside a little bit, so we'll just check around here on the back. There he is. Oh, that's good. You remembered my birthday. Thank you. This is great. And that is him at 10 hearts. Did I think he was at 10 hearts before? No, I don't think he was. So that is now Kent at 10 hearts as well. So we've just got Alex, Pierre, Penny, Vincent, George, and Sandy and the dwarf. And Krobus. I wonder what Krobus likes. I have no idea. What would it, this sewer dwelling rare salesperson want? I have no idea. Okay, well now we can go back and plant our tulips. For our tulip honey. Lovely. Right, back we are. And I think we picked up some strawberry seeds. No, we didn't. I think there were some just in the thing. In the seed maker. We've got a lot to plant though. We've got a lot to do. A lot to clean up as well, actually. So, plant the rest of these. As I say, no fertilizer because they're literally there to make the honey nice. I've been meaning to do this for such a long time and it's taken me so long to get around to it. It's unbelievable. I think I might have enough maple syrup now to be starting to make another row of bee houses too. But we'll see about that. So I'm going to actually just cut this grass away. Cut the weeds away around here as well. You can see a lot of grass growing though. But I don't want grass in this area. This is not the area for grass. And it's good to cut it away so that we've got to fodder in there for the animals, so that's always good. Just do a general tidy up around everywhere. I allow trees to grow here, so that's fine. Don't allow wood or stones to be around here though. I should check out the quarry and see if there's any like cool stuff there, like iridium. Mind you, iridium's about the only thing I get excited about now, because and that not particularly, because I need battery packs even to make the iridium sprinklers, so I can make maybe one at the moment. Get rid of these weeds. Get rid of these logs. This is a lot quicker than it used to be. Yeah, pick up this truffle off the floor. Get rid of that stone. Get rid of these weeds. I will leave that grass there for now, I think. Get rid of those. Just a little bit of tidying up and general maintenance, to be honest. We'll do a little bit of path building as well, just get all that sorted out. One thing that is a shame is that you can't see the whole of your farm. I'd love to see how it looks overall. It'd be pretty interesting, I think. Also, I'm pretty sure I'm gonna probably build maybe another shed and then a slime hutch pretty soon as well. But I would kind of like to see the farm, you know, in its full glory before I wrap the series up. I'd like to try and get it the way I wanted it originally. It's taken, I'd say, a couple of years to get that done, in game time anyway. So it's kind of nice now it actually is near that stage. Right, let's go see if there's any more strawberry seeds to be put down. And then I'll plant my potato and kale, and then it'll probably be time for bed. Actually got a path I can put down there. That's a bit better. Now, yes, we did have some more. I thought we did. Just another three, though. I think we already have some fertilised ground that I can put that on. Think anyway. Possibly not though. Yeah, we've got two spaces and we've got three seeds. Typical. one down there. Okay, so I think all this area here can be kind of strawberries. And then probably this area over this side can be for the kale and potatoes. So, and we're literally growing kale and potatoes so that we can make breakfasts and salmon suppers. Although I think salmon, I don't know if you can get salmon in spring. I'll have to have a little look and see what kind of time of year and where they need to be got. I have no problem with using the wiki for fish because they are a nightmare. There's so many of them to remember. Actually, I don't know why I'm doing those ones down there because we're only going to really need 4 patches. Because I like to just, you know, abuse my newly gained energy reserves. Must be so bad, like, before you get any of the star drops. I barely even remember a day before we had star drops. We just had, like, 100 or whatever it was. It's apparently getting late, but I'm nearly done with everything I need to do. So we'll carry on quickly, get those planted, and then that will be the end of the episode. But it's going to be nice when all these come to fruition. So I have potato seeds, and I have kale seeds. Boop, 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 boop. I need a Junimo planter now. I just give them seeds to plant and they just plant them. Although that would be harder, I think, because you'd have to tell them where to plant them. Whereas harvesting, it can just be like, yeah, anything in the range, it just gets harvested. But that is it for today, I think. So that was lovely. So we had a little bit of time planting. We had a little cutscene, I think. We sold some stuff. We got a... Oh, spreading weeds have caused damage. I think it's a rainy day today as well. So I don't need to water anything. Oh yeah, I don't need to water anything anyway. Hee hee hee. So anyway, we got our honey all sorted out. And just generally did a lot of stuff. So I think in the next couple of episodes, I'm just going to pause it in case the time goes on a bit too much. Although I'll probably be, well, I might carry on recording after this. We'll see. What was I saying? Oh yeah, so we're probably going to need to do a bit of remodeling on the house, just making the farm a bit prettier, giving Elliot and Alex some more things to get them to like me. And then, although I think Elliot's up there now. Elliot just needs a bouquet, sorry. And we just need to give Alex his salmon dinners, and we'll keep giving him eggs until that point, until we've got the potatoes and the kale grown. And then hopefully once we've done that, probably the second or third week of spring, we'll hopefully be able to get him up to the place where we want him to be. And then we can give him a bouquet as well, and that'll be the last one. Try and get all the cutscenes, and then I will decide who I want to marry. And at that point, I will probably be looking at wrapping this up, unless I find something more interesting to do. But we'll see. We'll see where that goes. Anyway, that's the end of the episode for today. I hope you liked it. And if you did, then please leave me a like below. That was bleh, wasn't it? And if you'd like to follow the series, please subscribe. And I'll let you know when the new videos are out. I hope to see you next time. But in the meantime, please look after yourselves and keep being awesome.